Hey, Brett McFall here. Hey, are you getting paid what you're worth? Are you? Are you getting paid exactly what you're worth? Are you happy with what you get paid? As in, are you happy what your employer pays you or what your clients pay you? Do you think you're getting paid enough? Would you like to get paid more? What I find is most people do. They feel like they're actually discounting their services because they don't know any better. They don't know how to actually charge high and get away with it, so to speak. They don't know how to value their services. They don't know how to find clients who actually will pay that money. So therefore, you settle and you try and keep the money coming in. Just keep all the plates spinning, right? And so let me tell you how to fix that and fix it really easily. How to get paid what you're worth. Now realize this, I worked for 12 years, so from between 19, for about 12 or 13 years since I was 19, I worked in advertising agencies, advertising departments, and I learnt the skill of copywriting. And so what I did is I was actually selling my time to my employers, getting awesome experience, and I loved the career, loved copywriting, I still love it today, but I was getting paid X amount to deliver Y result, okay? Until I got sick of that and realized that, gee, life was gonna be pretty hard. Paying off a mortgage was gonna be very, very hard. It was gonna be a lifetime thing if I didn't change the amount of income. So my next question was, well, how do I change how I leverage what my skills are, right? Because I knew there's other people out there who were leveraging it much higher than I, and generally they had a business. If they had a business, then they knew how to market properly and knew how to sell properly, and I wasn't in that space. So then I thought, well, if I learn how to do that, then won't I be fine? Won't I be able to charge a higher price? And it's true, I was. I simply learned how to do it, and then I've been unemployed ever since, and in my own business and be able to charge incredibly high prices, still give awesome value, by the way, at least 10 times the value back in return, but knowing how to leverage my asset, how to actually, you know, get paid what I knew was worth, as in my knowledge, my experience, my skills, I'm able to get paid now for what I know it's worth. Now, are you able to do that? If you're not, then what you're doing is you are wasting your asset. So whether an employer is paying you or a client is paying you, you are wasting your asset. Now, how do I know this? Because I work in 100 different niches right now. I talk to people like you every day, coaches, consultants, speakers, authors, online course creators, and I see a consistent problem in that you are not charging what you're worth. Maybe you're charging an hourly rate, let's say between $80, $150 per hour, and you're doing that because everyone else in your niche is doing the same. I get it. You're following everyone else, and if that's what everyone else is charging, it makes sense why you'd have to charge that as well. Except, no, you don't have to, all right? Maybe you charge a monthly rate of X thousand dollars per month. Whatever it is, it's usually lower than what you want, okay? Maybe you charge a percentage of profits. Again, it's usually lower than you want, usually, all right? So how do you change that? You've got to realize is that, first thing you've got to realize is you are wasting your asset right now. What you know, what you've done, and what you can do is something very valuable, right? And it's more valuable than maybe you even think about. It's usually, if your knowledge, your experience, your skills can provide a really good outcome for a client, that they end up profiting, they are benefiting, they end up having a much better result in any capacity. It might be money related, it might just be health related, it might be anything at all, but a better result than what they're getting, then you need to be able to value that for what it really is. It's like if you ask, you know, there's an old story there, if you ask a plumber to come to your house and he or she changes a washer and stops that tap from dripping, you know, the washer itself might cost 20 cents, but you're going to pay that plumber maybe $200 to do it, all right? And of course, you're not paying for the washer. What you're paying for is the knowledge, the experience on how to fix that leak, right? And this is what I want you to realize. It's all about that end result and valuing what that real end result is that you provide for your client. So it's about leveraging your asset. Right now, you're under-leveraging it. You are wasting your asset. If you're getting paid an hourly rate, you're wasting your asset. So the first thing to do is to realize that you are wasting your asset, that there is a better way. So for me, you know, most consultants and coaches, you know, it means that there are thousands of people out there who need and want what you've got. They would love to have access to what it is you do, but they can't access you because maybe you only work with local people. They have to be, as in those people need to be near you in order for you to help them. You don't work remotely, or you don't have any coaching program for them to buy into. You've got a website, but there's nothing on there to buy, and if there is something on there to buy, it's poorly marketed, so no one buys it. So, you know, there are thousands of people out there waiting for you, would love to be able to spend money with you, but they can't access you, your knowledge, your experience, your skills. That's the problem. And of course, the person who's benefiting the least from this asset, your asset, is you and maybe your family, consequently, right? But you own the asset and you're wasting it, all right? So it's crazy, it's absolutely crazy. You must learn how to leverage your asset, get more return from the same asset, right? So that's the first thing that's got to happen, right? You've got to realize that what you're doing is wasting your asset. Where instead, you've got now got to learn how to leverage the asset, but how to have a consulting program, a coaching program, any sort of training at all, but in a way which allows you to charge a higher price for less time and be able to have clients on tap. Now, what that usually means is working one to many, all right? If you're not getting paid what you're worth, first we need to increase your prices to something that represents a result. So I'm not paying you for your hourly rate anymore, I'm paying you for a result. So for instance, instead of getting paid, like I take students who normally get paid say $80 to $120 per hour, and suddenly they change their business model and now have a program, a course, which promises a result. It sells for between $3 and $10,000. So every time they take a client on, instead of an $80 to $120 hour rate, they suddenly are starting at between $3,000 and $10,000 package. So the client actually invests somewhere between $3,000 and $10,000, usually up front. Now that's a massive difference. Because they stop selling their time, they start selling a result. They start selling a result. Does that make sense to you? Massive shift. Massive shift in your results. Okay, so that's the lesson what you take away from this. If you're not getting paid what you're worth, realize that you are undervaluing your asset. In fact, you are severely wasting the asset because you're not actually choosing to leverage it in a better way. And how you leverage it is usually by packaging up a service, a result, into a price, somewhere over 3,000, right? So now if you do get paid the 3,000, it's now worth your while to spend time on a client, to actually help them, they really need help. So to spend time with them, that's what it's all about. You've now incentivized, you've now got enough money in the bank to justify it, rather than getting an hourly rate which just ticks over and you're trying to pay your bills and all the rest. So get the higher dollars up front by changing the system completely by promising a result. All right. Does that help you out? I'm Brett McFall, and I hope that helps you out. Yeah, talk to you soon. Hey, Brett McFall here again. Now, if you enjoyed that lesson, then you might also want to learn some more from me. And if you do, then I've got a link on this page or nearby this video at the very least, where I can show you how to fix all your marketing problems. What I do is if you've got problems in how to attract customers, how to get charged more for your product or service, then I have the systems that can help you do that, and I'll teach you in a very easy way. So click on the link, and I'll show you how I can help you, and I'll see you there.